In this module, we'll cover the three components of your printer called consumables. These items are considered an exhaustible resource on your printer and will need to be replaced over the course of printing. The Form 3 and 3L series printers have three consumables: the resin tank, the build platform, and the resin cartridge. Let's start with the resin tank. The resin tank is where the printing happens. The liquid resin inside the tank is cured here into solid layers. The most critical piece of the tank is the tank film. The flexible tank film helps parts release. This is what the laser passes through to connect with the resin. It is important to keep the tank film free of debris. You should never touch the tank film with your fingers or gloves, or place the tank down on an unclean work surface. Never use IPA to clean the inner tank film, and never use anything sharp when interacting with the tank film, as it could puncture. The tank film is attached to the rest of the tank via the tank skirt. The black strip of VHB tape holds the tank film and tank skirt together. Let's flip the tank over to view it from another angle. The tank ID chip connects with prongs on the printer's tower to detect the presence of a resin tank. It is also programmable and stores information like what resin type the tank is being used with, the date it was first filled, and how many hours of printing it has been used for. Flipping the tank back right side up, we've also moved the tank mixer out of its hiding place. When activated by the printer, the tank mixer moves across the full length of the tank film using the tank mixer magnets, mixing the resin together and leaving an even coating of resin on top of the film. Resin enters the tank via the tank spout. This is a ramp that gently guides resin from the cartridge into the resin tank. Finally, by removing the mixer and looking into the left side of the tank, we have the tank float. The float consists of a hollow plastic component that floats on the resin and an aluminum counterweight that interacts with a component in the printer's tower called the level sense board. This allows the printer to measure the resin level of the tank and signal when it needs more. Your resin tank will come with a storage case to store the tank when it's not in use. In both styles of cases, the orange hue will block ambient light to prevent liquid resin in the tank from curing. While the information about your used tank is stored on the tank's ID chip, it is helpful to label your resin tank boxes for easy identification. A sheet of stickers comes with each resin cartridge. The Form 3L resin tank has a lot of similarities to the Form 3 tank in that it has the same flexible tank film and black tank skirt, just scaled up to a larger size. Let's rotate the tank around and focus in on the back right corner. Here's where we will see some differences. Rather than a chip, the Form 3L resin tank uses an RFID sticker hidden on the inside of the tank skirt and not visible in this photo to store tank information. This RFID sticker will interact with a sensor on the printer's tower. The tank spout has also shifted to the side of the tank where it lines up with the cartridge slots. Turning the resin tank back around, the tank mixer is installed on the right side of the resin tank near the tank spout. It uses a similar set of magnets for controlling mixer movement. The Form 3L's sturdy resin tank box helps you store your resin tanks when not in use. Because the tank film is flexible and the Form 3L resin tank holds almost a full liter of resin, the tank film may sag when it is not in the printer. Don't worry, this is normal. The tank film is tensioned during printing. On both the Form 3 and Form 3L, resin tanks will need to be replaced at regular health intervals. The lifetime of your resin tank will vary based on the resin you're using. Always refer to the Formlabs support article on resin tank lifetime and monitoring to see the most up-to-date information on tank lifetimes. When a resin tank is installed, press the tank icon on the touchscreen to see the tank lifetime screen. When a tank is close to expiration, the printer will begin to pop up warnings to replace your resin tank. When a tank is ready to be retired, simply transfer the resin from the old tank to a fresh tank. Once the resin is transferred, insert the new resin tank, and start a print to assign it to the correct resin type and fill date. Next, we'll discuss the different build platforms available for the Form 3 and Form 3L series printer. All four build platforms serve the same function. They are the surface that resin cures to, allowing subsequent print layers to build off of them. We'll start with the basic Form 3 model, just called build platform. The build platform has a machined aluminum print surface. The first layer of a print will cure directly to the build plate, and every other layer will build off the previous layer. The surface of the build platform will be very smooth when you first use it. The handle interacts with the build platform carriage to insert and lock the build platform into place. Users will also hold the build platform by its handle when transferring the platform on and off the printer. Over time, with the removal of parts, your build platform will get scraped by your tools. As scuffs and scrapes accumulate, your parts will adhere more firmly to the build platform. If parts become too difficult to remove, it may be time to replace your build platform. The Build Platform 2 is an upgraded build platform designed to allow users to quickly remove their parts. The Build Platform 2 uses a stainless steel print surface, which can be bent to release parts. Users release parts by pressing the part release paddles, which will bend the surface to pop off your parts or loosen them for easy manual removal. Users can remove the print surface for cleaning. The print surface attaches to the build platform body, where the alignment rods and alignment channels align to ensure a correct fit. The build platform body also has magnets inside, ensuring the print surface stays in place. Like the other Form 3 build platform, the Build Platform 2 uses the same handle. The Form 3L platform uses the same print surface as the Form 3 build platform. The carriage slot helps the platform slide and lock into the build platform carriage on the printer. And because of its size, the Form 3L build platform has two handles for easy maneuvering. Not visible in the photo is an RFID sticker hidden inside the build platform. This sticker is read by an RFID reader inside the printer, confirming the presence of the build platform. The Build Platform 2L is an upgraded build platform, just like the Form 3 Build Platform 2. Because of its scaled-up design, users release parts by pressing the part release tabs, which will bend the surface. You can also remove the print removal surface for cleaning. The system of alignment rods and channels and magnetic surface mimic the Build Platform 2. The Build Platform 2L uses generally the same handle setup, along with the RFID sticker for detection. Finally, let's cover the resin cartridge. This is a resin cartridge. It is a resin container which holds resin in reserve during the print process, refilling the resin tank when necessary. Both the Form 3 and Form 3L series printers use the same resin cartridge. The resin is stored in the cartridge body. This hollow container holds 1 liter of resin. Affixed to the bottom of the body is the cartridge skirt, including the components that will directly interface with the printer. On the top of the cartridge body sits the vent cap. Opening the vent cap allows air to flow into the cartridge, preventing a vacuum seal when resin is dispensed. Next, let's review the components attached to the cartridge skirt. First, we have the bite valve. The bite valve will have a slit cut into it that remains closed when not engaged with. The printer dispenses resin by pressing on the bite valve. Next is the cartridge ID chip. This is how the printer detects the presence of the cartridge and identifies the resin type and version contained within it. And finally, we have the ID sticker. This sticker will have the resin name and version number, as well as the lot number and expiration date of the resin. You can use this sticker to monitor your resin stock and ensure you're always using the oldest cartridges first. Most resins have a 24-month shelf life. It is always recommended to check your bite valve before you begin printing with a new cartridge. Press gently on the bite valve to ensure the slit is fully opened. If necessary, a thin, blunt object, such as the corner of a business card, can be used to break a seal on a bite valve or dislodge clotted resin. Always contact Formlabs if your bite valve will not open. using a sharp object could open the bite valve too wide, which creates a higher risk of resin spills. On the Form 3, the resin cartridge is inserted into the printer's tower. On the Form 3L, there are slots for two resin cartridges on the printer's right side. On the Form 3L, cartridges must be the same resin type for a print to start, but it will also start a print with a single cartridge inserted, as long as there is enough resin to complete the print. When you are ready to begin printing, the printer will remind you to open the vent cap. This will ensure that resin can flow into the tank when the bite valve is pressed by the printer's dispense arm. Vent caps should be closed when putting a resin cartridge into storage. We hope this module helped you understand your printer's consumables. If you ever have questions about your printer's consumables, visit our support site at support.formlabs.com or email us at support@formlabs.com.